Good morning, scientists. Good morning, scientists. Good morning, scientists. I'm so glad you're here today.
Yay!
Wow, it's so good to see each and every one of you. I have missed you so much. We haven't had science class in such a long time that I thought it would be really fun if I brought science class to you at your house. First thing we're gonna do, does anybody remember what this thing is? I think I hear it. Yes, it's our mystery box. And does anybody remember why we call it a mystery box? Because we don't know what's in it. It's a mystery. So let's look inside and see if we can figure out what we're gonna talk about today. Whoa! Look at this. Does anybody know what this is called? Ask your mom or your dad if you don't know what it is. This is called a lava lamp. And this is something Miss Scott used to have when she was a little girl. And I had it right beside my bed. And I would look at it for hours and hours and hours and watch all the things move around inside. Today, I'm going to teach you how to make your very own lava lamp. Isn't that cool? The first thing we're going to do is get all of our ingredients together. We need an empty water bottle. We need some cooking oil. Now, these are all things that your mom probably has in her house already, so you can do this at home with her. Then we're going to use something called Alka-Seltzer. Does anybody know what this is for? This is something you take when your tummy's upset and it makes you feel better. And then we need some food coloring so we can make it a pretty color. Now, the first thing we do when we do our experiment is to measure out some water. I have some plain water in here. And for this experiment, it tells me that I want to have about a fourth of the bottle with water in it. So I'm going to measure it out. I've already measured ahead of time, so I know exactly how much to put in here. So I'm going to pour this water into the bottom of the bottle. Does that look like anything right now?
No.
Does that look like a lava lamp?
No.
Next thing we're gonna do is add some oil. Now what we're gonna do with this oil is pour it very, very slowly into the bottle. See if you can see what's happening here.
Does it mix?
What's happening? It looks like the oil is staying on top of the water. Let's see when we get it all in here, what happens. Probably need a little bit more oil. I think you're right, Miss Frances.
Looks like it won't mix together.
I don't think it's mixing together. Does anybody have any idea why that might be happening? Remember before we were talking about density? Water is heavier or denser than the oil, so it sinks to the bottom. The oil is lighter. Can you see where the water's at the bottom and the oil sits on the top? Now, we are going to add some color in here. What do you think about purple? Is that a good color?
Yes.
Let's make a purple.
Purple.
We love purple.
Does that look like a lava lamp right there?
It's all about to.
Now we're gonna add 10 drops. One, two, three. Now look and see what's happening. Four, five, six. What are the drops of color doing? Are they floating on the top? Are they mixing up with the oil?
They're sinking.
7, 8, 9, 10. Let's see what happens. They're kind of sitting right on top of the water, but they're not mixing with the oil. Now let's sit here for a few seconds and see if anything happens. Remember what that word is that we were talking about? Density. So we said density means how heavy it is. So the oil is lighter than the water and it sits on the top. The water is denser than the oil, so it's heavier and it sinks to the bottom. Nothing's happening right now. Let's see what happens when we add one of these Alka-Seltzer tablets. Now, like I said, this is something that your mom might give you when you've got a tummy ache or something. So your mom's gotta be with you when you do this experiment. Now let's see what happens when we put this in here. Does anybody have any ideas what might happen? Let's look and see. What do you think the Alka-Seltzer is gonna do?
Oh.
It sinks to the bottom. But look, what's it doing?
Look at that, look close.
It's making bubbles.
Yes.
Look at that. Look.
It looks like an explosion.
It's making an explosion of color. We're making our own lava lamp. Why do you think that is? What do you think happened there? I'm going to tell you what happened. The Alka-Seltzer makes lots of little tiny bubbles at the bottom. And as those bubbles get bigger and bigger, they start going to the top. And when they go to the top, they take the colored water up with them to the top. And the gas that the bubbles make comes out the top of the bottle, and then the bubbles fall back down. Look at that. It goes over and over and over again.
Wow, that's clever.
What do you think would happen if I put some more in there?
Let's see.
Let's see. Do you think it would start up again?
I bet so.
There it goes. Look at it.
Look at
it's
that.
Starting over again. Isn't that fun?
I can't wait to make one.
That's our lava lamp. Now, let's try this. I thought it might be interesting to see what do you think would happen if we added. Ooh, here's one I did earlier today. This is a blue one. Do you think anything would happen if I added something back to it? Let's look and see.
I think so.
Let's look and see. Everything is down at the bottom. This is water in the food color. And it's lighter. I mean, it's heavier than the oil is, so it's down at the bottom. So we're going to see what happens when we add the Alka-Seltzer.
Oh.
There it is.
There it goes. There it goes. Look at that.
That's
one.
So neat.
Look at
Ooh.
That. Can you zoom in on that?
Yes, ma'am. We're zoomed.
That's
it looks really good.
I thought this would be kind of cool. What would happen, do you think, if we put some glitter in it?
Oh, yeah. You know, I love glitter.
Kind of hard to see. You might come up here, Miss Frances.
We got a pretty close photo. Let's see.
So what's happening is the glitter is going down with the colored bubbles, but then it comes back up to the top. Pretty cool, don't
so
you think?
So neat.
That's so cool.
So let's see if I have any more Alka-Seltzer. Let's see if we can get this guy going again.
Miss Scott, can we do it in a smaller bottle if we don't have a big one?
You can do it in a smaller bottle. You can do it in a bigger bottle. But what you need to do is make sure that the bottom is about a fourth of it in water and then the rest is oil.
Okay.
And you need to leave a little bit at the top so that it doesn't spill over. So like I said, I did this one this morning. But as you can see, if you put some more Alka-Seltzer in there, about a half of a tablet. It'll start all over again. Let's see if we can get this one to start all over again. Ooh, the glitter.
Look at that.
There it goes.
There it goes. Now, I don't have a light on this one, but I bet you if you shine a flashlight on it, it'll look a lot like this one.
Mm-hmm.
Now, one thing that I found out that's really cool. When these settle down and stop bubbling, you can put a top on it.
Oh,
you
yeah.
can do it again tomorrow.
Uh-huh.
Just by adding some more Alka-Seltzer.
So neat.
Have fun making your lava lamp at home with your mom or your dad.
Okay.
See you soon.